If you see my latest e-commerce website, you know that I am using a lot of images inside of this website. And those images are causing a little bit of a problem. On mobile, I have really good scores. And remember, this website has not been optimized with any caching plugin. It's not in there. It's just Elementor Pro out of the box. But when you scroll down, we can see there is a little bit of a problem with the largest Contentful paint. And also the first Contentful paint could be upped a lot because the speed index is just way low because of those images. Also on desktop, you can see it takes just 2.3 seconds. On GG Metrics, you can see exactly where it goes wrong. If we scroll down, we can see over here the top issues. Avoid enormous network payloads because all these hero images, look at it, they're not that big individual scene, but it adds up. So what we need to do is we need to make sure that all these images are just way smaller. To do that, we're going to make use of a tool. So go to wp.discount/image optimizer. Now this link is also in the description of this video and in the comment section. The first optimization is free, but if you decide to buy a plan, I get a small commission, so thank you very much. And then we are at the website of Elementor. Speed up your website with Image Optimizer. Well, press on this button, try Image Optimizer. We also have a free trial. I'll be demonstrating that one to you in this tutorial, but you can also use different kind of plans if you have a lot of images on your website or you are constantly uploading more images because you have a blog or some other website with a lot of images. In the first year, you also get discounts for the amount of credits that you buy. One credit will optimize one image. However, WordPress automatically creates 5 basic sizes. Now, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you exactly that you can turn those optimizations for every image off. So it will save you some credits and only makes you optimize what you want. You can also optimize single images. And that's what I'm going to demonstrate you right now in this free trial. So we press on try it for free. Then you need to sign in with Elementor. And if you already have an Elementor account, because I have Elementor Pro, then all is good. And we can just press on start free trial. And then we click over here on download image optimizer. Now it has been downloaded to our computer. Log into your WordPress website. If you're still logging in using WP admin, not a very safe way. So please watch my tutorial about securing your WordPress website. Then we go over here to plugins, add new plugin. Then press on upload plugin. And we're going to select the file we've just downloaded from Elementor. And then we press on install now. Of course, we want to activate this plugin. And the plugin has been activated. And we press over here on take me there. Let's start optimizing our images. So we press connect to start. Then we get another screen that we have to log in to Elementor. Well, we've already been logged in, so we just press connect and continue. And then we are at the dashboard of Image Optimizer. We can see how many space we've saved, how many images are optimized, and how many images are in our plan. Well, if we scroll down, we can see even more information. We have subscription status, we are active. Then we have the compression level. If image quality needs to be perfect, then you can go with lossless. And this way you will not see any difference between the original image and this image. In our case, I'm going with lossy because I think you will not see it anyway. But you can always try and recover your original images if you're not happy with the results. Then we can optimize new uploads. So if you upload new images, they will automatically be optimized. This is very useful if you have a blog or you're generating a lot of pages and posts in a regular level. Then we have resize larger images. So this allows larger images resizes to maximum of this dimensions. If you have images that are bigger than that, or you just have a client that keeps uploading gigantic images, then this is a very useful option to have enabled. Then you can clear your EXIF metadata, like date, time, location already inserted inside of your images. It will save some space, so let's keep it on. Backup your originals. also important, and then we can convert them to a different format. Now, this is where the biggest optimization battle is being won, because WebB or AFIF are really great formats to make these images really small. Now, what we want to do, I want to have superior compression. So I'm going with AFIF, but if you're worried about compatibility, you should choose WebP. I'm just going to try AFIF and see how that works. And then we are at the file optimization, which is very important. If you go here to all sizes and you click on custom, you will see that WordPress generates from one image you upload all these different kind of sizes on your site. Yes, you heard that right. WordPress will do that with every single image that you upload. Now, the thing is, if you don't use these custom sizes, and the Elementor Image Optimizer will optimize all these files, it will count as credits. In my case, I don't want that. So I'm just going to deselect thumbnail, medium, medium, large, and large. And I'm only going to use this one. And I also don't want to optimize the WooCommerce files. I just want to start with the original ones and see if that really makes a difference in our website speed. And then last but not least, we go to advanced actions. Here we can restore our original images, remove backups permanently, and switch account for my subscription settings. And then we go and optimize our images. We can do this in two ways. First, you can go to bulk optimization. You can just press this start button and it will start optimizing all your images. In my case, what I want to see is if I optimize my header images, will it make a difference on my speed score? Of course. So to do that, you go to your library. Also in here, you can press on optimize all and it will start to optimize every image on your website. But in my case, I only want to optimize my header page. And after that, we can start the bulk optimization. That's fine. But I want to test it out. So we scroll down. And these are my hero files. All these ones. So I click on one of them. And I press optimize now. All right, it's done. And we can see it's been optimized. Three sizes has been optimized. Overall savings is 443 kilobytes on three savings. So per saving just 100 kilobyte. Well, let's see. I'm just going to press on this previous button and also going to optimize this one and also going to optimize this one. And I'm also going to optimize this one and also this one. Here we go. Just want to optimize all my hero images. There we go. If you encounter this error, optimization error, just press on try again. Might be that the server of Elementor is a bit busy, or your own server is a bit busy, or there's some other problems. Just try again and it will. I now click through all my images, you can see that they are all optimized. So that's really nice. Once I've optimized those ones, the next ones that are very important are, of course, my logo. There we go. So I'm going to optimize it. And after this one, I also want to optimize these ones, as these are a drop down in my mega menu on my e-commerce website, so they will be always loaded. So press optimize now, optimize now, optimize now, optimize it. Here we go. Now the plugin will also optimize all these images inside of my mega menu that are actually clickable images to go to that specific product. And then we scroll all the way up and then we can see that we have a 7% space saved. 35% of images are optimized on my website. So we have only 69 images to really optimize yet. Now this looks really amazing. Of course, I'm now interested in my speed score if it goes up. And as you can see in my header now, when I choose this image, you will see that it's been loaded now in an AFIF format. So that actually works. I don't have to change it manually. All these things are being automated because it's an Elementor system. It works perfectly with my Elementor Pro website. All right, so the results are in this PageSpeed Insight on desktop. This was what it was. Largest Contentful Paint 2.3, 82 performance. On mobile, 68. 8.6 seconds. All right, that was original. So it actually is becoming slower. I don't think this is correct. But if we go to the desktop, we can see that performance is now on a 90 because the largest Contentful Paint has been dropped down to 0.5 seconds, which is actually the way it's supposed to be. Now remember, there's no caching plugin whatsoever installed on this website. This is just Elementor Pro out of the box with WooCommerce installed on it. So that's actually a really good score with our newest improved images. Just a quick heads up, I restored the original images because I really liked the quality of my images. And of course, this is a tutorial how to create the most beautiful website. You can follow it over here. 5.5 hours. I will show you exactly how to do it. But I need this website to look really good. And speed, well, it's not of the essence right now. If you have any questions, just drop it down in the comments. I always reply. Have an awesome day. Hope to see you in the next video.